We know you've missed going back to school to meet with your friends, resume your activities, and just be able to get back to how life was like on campus. But for the UMians who didn't get to set foot on campus yet, whether you are in basic education, senior high school, or college, let's take a little trip to the campus you can hopefully get to visit soon as you finish your education with UM. Luckily, we've got some of our beloved teachers to show you around UM's colleges and campuses, so you'll know what to expect when you come back to school.
It's only proper to start to the place where it all began. The UM Bolton and Embassy Campus were among the first structures to be put up as the University of Mindanao was starting to make a name for itself 75 years ago. Here at the Bolton side, you can find many of the offices for student services like the registrar, student accounting office, and cashier, among others. There's also a canteen where students and employees can purchase healthy food. Going further into Bolton campus, you can find on the first floor the College of Legal Education, where aspiring lawyers take their Juris Doctor degrees. There is even a dedicated library for law students across the cool and shaded quadrangle. On your way to the staircase to get the second floor, you get to pass by the AVR3, where lots of programs and other small gatherings are held. Going up to the second floor, you can find the office of the College of Business Administration Education. UM is the only school in Mindanao granted a Center of Excellence by CHED for its business and management programs, as well as level 4 accreditation by the PACOCOA. So if you're planning on a career in business-related dealings, the CBAE is for you. Our college offers the following programs under the Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, Major in Entrepreneurship, Legal Management, Real Estate Management, Marketing Management, Financial Management, Human Resource Management, and the new program, Major in Business Analytics. The third floor also houses our expansive library and information center. That covers the Bolton side. Let's head on over to the Embassy campus. Across the UM Bolton is the Embassy side, and it's named that way because it used to be the grounds for Japanese Embassy back in World War II. Today, it is a sprawling area that houses the gymnasium for large UM events, our admission office, our Center for Health Services, or the student clinic and the external relation office out front on the first floor. Going up, you can find the International Affairs Office where matters for foreign exchange students are processed among others. And walking further, you will find the office of the Senior High School Department. Outside of the Embassy campus, on the Ponciano side, we have the UM Multitest Diagnostic Center, which offers various laboratory services like blood testing, x-ray, and doctor consultations. UM Bolton and Embassy campus are located at the heart of downtown Davao, so it's easy to commute from here to many other places you might need to go. And speaking of which, did you know that UM has a campus at Matina? I'll send you over to our teacher friends in Matina campus and they can show you around.
We're now inside the University of Mindanao's largest campus, the 28-hectare Matina campus encompasses the Matina area going up to Maa. Right beside the Gravahan exit is the Basic Education Building where it caters from kindergarten up to junior high school students with lots of space for learning and play.
Going further inside the campus, you'll spot the four-story business engineering building. Its first and second floor houses laboratories for engineering programs. It is the premier engineering school for its level 4 accreditation granted by the PACOCOA and the Center of Development Status by the Commission in Higher Education. UM College of Engineering offers the following programs: Bachelor of Science in Chemical Engineering, Bachelor of Science in Mechanical Engineering, Bachelor of Science in Electrical Engineering, Bachelor of Science in Electronics Engineering, Bachelor of Science in Computer Engineering, and Bachelor of Science in Civil Engineering, major in Structural, Water Resource, Transportation, and Geotechnical. The third floor of the BE building is home to Davao Region's roster of top-notchers of the CPA licensure examination. The College of Accounting Education has Level 3 accreditation from FACTECOA and is certified by the Commission on Higher Education as a Center of Development. The College of Accounting Education offers the following programs: Bachelor of Science in Accountancy, Bachelor of Science in Internal Auditing, Bachelor of Science in Accounting Information System, Bachelor of Science in Management Accounting. The Learning and Information Center takes up the entire topmost floor of the BE building. It houses all the university's books available for borrowing.
Let's take a scenic trip to the College of Hospitality Education.
Located near the UM Athena Gymnasium, the College of Hospitality Education has Level 3 accreditation from FACTECOA and offers the following programs: Bachelor of Science in Hospitality Management and Bachelor of Science in Tourism Management. The College of Hospitality Education also has industry-level facilities like the La Spezia Mini Hotel, the Function Hall, and the Kitchen and Bakery areas. Located behind the gymnasium is the UM Hangar, where students can test their inventions and other experiments. The hangar holds the university's Coleoptera Research Center, the first university-based center in the Philippines dedicated to study the conservation and cataloging of Philippine beetle species. Every large university, such as UM, has a place where students gather for major events. And UM doesn't just have its bolt-on gymnasium. We also have the Matina Gymnasium too, equipped with fold-away bleachers and professional standard flooring for the courts. The gym is the perfect venue for sporting and other extracurricular activities.
Despite being a bustling school, there's plenty of space in UM Matina for some quiet time and to be surrounded by nature.
UM Matina has a mini forest with tables and benches, because UM believes that learning and rest isn't just limited to the walls of a room. Is this tour making you a little hungry? Across the gymnasium is the university canteen and food court, which serves a variety of affordable meals, snacks, and drinks, where students can eat comfortably. Tables are regularly sanitized and electric fans are provided.
Let's head down to the GET building.
Named after the school's founder, Guillermo E. Torres, the building is home to Davao Region's producer of top-notchers in the licensure examinations for teachers. The College of Teacher Education offers the following programs: Bachelor of Elementary Education, Bachelor of Early Childhood Education, Bachelor of Special Needs Education, Bachelor of Physical Education, and Bachelor in Secondary Education, major in Biological Sciences, English, Social Studies, Filipino, and Mathematics. Also, found on the first floor of the GET building is the Audiovisual Room 2, an air-conditioned and carpeted, fully equipped facility with cinema-style folded seating, which is frequently used for different programs. The second and third floor of the GET building is occupied by the premier criminology school in Davao, the College of Criminal Justice Education. The CCJE offers Bachelor of Science in Criminology and Bachelor of Science in Industrial Security Management. Heading further inside the campus, away from GET, we'll reach the DPT building. Named after former school president Dolores P. Torres, the four-story building houses the mini auditorium, the quality management office, research and publication center, Institute of Pedagogical and Assessment Center, some laboratories, and pocket gardens on its first floor. Located on the DPT's second floor is the College of Arts and Sciences Education. CASE offers the following programs: Bachelor of Arts in English, Bachelor of Arts in Communication, Bachelor of Science in Environmental Science, Bachelor of Science in Agroforestry, Bachelor of Science in Forestry, Bachelor of Science in Biology, Bachelor of Science in Mathematics, Bachelor of Arts in Political Science, Bachelor of Science in Public Administration, Bachelor of Science in Psychology, and Bachelor of Science in Social Work. The third floor of the DPT building houses the College of Health Sciences Education, or the CHSE. CHSE offers Bachelor of Science in Nursing, Bachelor of Science in Pharmacy, Bachelor of Science in Medical Technology, and Bachelor of Science in Nutrition and Dietetics. Sharing the floor with CHSE is the College of Computing Education. CCE offers Bachelor of Science in Computer Science, Bachelor of Science in Information Technology, Bachelor of Science in Information System, Bachelor of Science in Entertainment and Multimedia Computing, major in Game Development and Digital Animation. The topmost floor of the DPT building is home to the Creative Academic Unit of UM, the College of Architecture and Fine Arts Education. CAFAE offers Bachelor of Science in Architecture, Bachelor of Fine Arts major in Painting. Let's head back down and you'll see that across the DPT building is our Professional Schools building. It is led by its Dean Dr. Eugenio S. Guhao and serves to bring globally recognized ISO standard and PAKOKOA accredited postgraduate and doctorate degrees to more Dabawenyos. We're about to head out now, but before we leave, let's take a look at the UM Oval Track and Sports Stadium. It has a 400-meter rubberized track suitable for track and field training and other sporting activities. The sports stadium served as the venue for the 2019 Palerong Pambansa.
Thanks for joining this campus tour. Oh, by the way, even though UM is already a formidable university that is second in the whole Philippines to offer the most number of PAKOKOA accredited programs, we do not rest. The administration keeps on working very hard just to be sure that more Filipinos here and abroad are able to obtain quality, affordable, and open education. Hope to have you here at UM soon, ga!
All right, good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, mga ga, and welcome to the University of Mindanao. You've just seen the two campuses here in Davao City, and that's the UM Bolton campus and also the UM Matina campus. And hopefully soon, we'll be seeing you for a face-to-face tour of the university, but this time it's only a virtual tour. But anyway, hopefully that you're able to enjoy your tour this afternoon. By the way, we have this what we call SHS immersion webinar. This is actually an initiative of the University of Mindanao in support to the DepEd's work immersion implementation for all senior high school during this pandemic, during this COVID-19 pandemic. So the current crisis really limits you guys, the learners, the opportunities, not from reporting to work immersion. So mas maganda sana yun, that you go to a certain office and then you do some duties and responsibilities, so that you can really feel the immersion program for the senior high school, and also experience the usual pre and also post immersion activities. But worry no more, because the University of Mindanao offers this immersion webinar. And this afternoon, we will be focusing on the HRM and tourism industry. And right, and we have a lot of speakers. We have three speakers this afternoon that will give you a lot of inputs with regards to immersion program. And so to start our webinar this afternoon, let us be in the presence of God as the University of Mindanao Chorale will lead us in prayer through this song.
strumento della vostra pace.
Lord, make me an instrument of your peace.
Dove c'è odio, lasciarlo seminare l'amore. Dove ci è ferita, perdono. Dove ci è dubbio, fede. Dove ci è desperazione, sperare. Dove ci è nerezza, illuminarsi. Dove ci è la tristezza.
All right, again, good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, mga ga. Again, welcome to University of Mindanao and welcome to this Senior High School Immersion Webinar for the school year 2022. Okay, so we are actually live also, no, in our YouTube channel. So if you have problems with your connections as we go along with our webinar this afternoon, you can just go to our YouTube channel and you can still join our webinar. And also, you can invite your friends and classmates who are willing to join our immersion webinar. Maybe they have problems, no? That's they're not able to get, no, the link, no, on the email, maybe because there's an error on it. So you can just share, no, our link, no, for this afternoon's webinar. All right. So again, this is a free webinar, no, for you grade 12 students. This is an initiative of the University of Mindanao as a proactive response to our situation, or to this problem that we're having. All right, so we will discuss various topics, no, in this webinar, no, that are actually part of the curriculum, no, for the immersion webinar. I mean immersion subject ninyo. So these topics will cover on the key learning areas of the subject, like the pre-employment requirements, wherein we're going to talk about writing a winning cover letter, a resume, how to ace the interview, and work ethics and social media etiquette. And this afternoon also, we will be highlighting, no, your immersion to HRM and tourism. All right, so that's our episode. This is actually our third episode. And also, we will be talking, no, this afternoon with regards to why you should choose University of Mindanao. And these three topics now will be given to you this afternoon. And hopefully, you will grasp all the information. All right? So, sit back and relax, no? As we go, no, with our immersion this afternoon. Before we will go to the topics, no, that we're going to discuss this afternoon, let us just welcome, no, everyone, no, dito sa ating Zoom and also sa YouTube. May we request, no, once we will, I will call your school, kindly kaway-kaway, no, madali lang, turn on your video and then kaway-kaway kayo so that we can recognize, no, your schools. Of course, let's start with, of course, the University of Mindanao Senior High School, Maine. Ayan, kaway-kaway yung mga taga-UM. Ayan. All right. May we also recognize the New Ilang Achievers Academy Incorporated. Ayan. All right. Where are you? F. Bustamante National High School. All the way from Tibungco. Ayan. All right. So, nakikita ako mga students. Please, ha? Kaway-kaway. Or you can have your clapping, no? Virtual clap dyan. Okay? Where are you? AL Navarro National High School. Alright. Alright. Welcome to UM. Alright. Where are you? Kabantian National High School. Ayan. Kaway-kaway. You can clap. You can raise your hand. Any virtual, ano dyan? Emoticons. Alright. Where are you? Vicentan Nograles National High School. Ayan. Mag-ingay. Ayan. Alright. Where are you? Okay. This is my alma mater. Daniel R. Aguinaldo National High School. Alright. Alright. Where are you? Of course, di magpapatalo. Crossing Bayabas National High School. Alright. Where are you? Cebulan National High School. How about Digo Central Adventist Academy Incorporated? Alright, ayun, madami nag-raise ng hand. How about, of course, Kidapawan City National High School? Ayun, kaway-kaway, hello, hello, welcome. How about Mintal Comprehensive National High School? Hello, guys. How about Davao Doctors College? Ayun. And, of course, Mabini National High School. And didn't magpapatalo, where are you? Students from Davao City National High School. All right. Welcome, welcome. Welcome to the University of Mindanao immersion webinar. All right. Okay. So most of you here, guys, are from the strand, no, na tawag nito. General academic strand and also ayan, TVL na na strand. And meron din mga taga-UMS and other strand. So welcome. All right. So I believe, no, we are ready. Ayan. So let us start. No, let's begin our webinar this afternoon. So please also listen very carefully, no, because after every session, no, we're going to have a game. So, meron tayong pa-premyo later. So, later on, I will reveal kung ano yung pa-premyo natin. So, let's start. Our first topic this afternoon will be about pre-employment requirements. As being mentioned a while ago, we'll be talking about writing cover letter, resume, also how to ace the interview, work ethics, and social media etiquette. And to give us more information about those topics that I have mentioned, ladies and gentlemen, a virtual round of applause to the Vice President of External Relations and International Affairs of the University of Mindanao, Dr. Reynaldo C. Castro. Sir?
Thank you very much, Benji. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon to our senior high school students. I'm glad to see more than 90 participants here in our Zoom room. Welcome. As mentioned by Benji, this is our third batch, no? Third session for the immersion program. And my topic this afternoon is all about how are you going to write an application letter and resume? How are you going to prepare for job interview and social media etiquette? All right? Sige, let me share my screen first. Okay. There you go. And all right. So as I mentioned, these are the three topics, no, that I'm going to present to you this afternoon. These are very important, especially if you're going to apply for jobs, even after senior high school or even after your college, no. If you have seen, if you have find a good company, a good organization where there is an opportunity for you to work, and the first thing that you are going to do is that you're going to prepare for application letter and for your resume. Applying for jobs, senior high school students, you pass through certain process. No, the first process, the first stage that you are going to do is you're going to prepare these important documents. No, you will not just go there in the company. Hindi pwede na magpunta lang kayo diretso sa company, sa organization, sa office. Tapos sasabihin ninyo mag-a-apply kayo sa trabaho, okay? Kailangan, meron talaga proseso, no? You are going to prepare your application letter and your resume. Okay, once okay na kayo, after evaluating your documents, your resume, if the HR finds that you can proceed to the next level, then therefore, you will proceed to job interview. You will be scheduled for job interview. All right. And the third one is, you know, the background investigation. And that's why importante na tingnan natin yung ating mga social media account, yung ating Facebook account, yung ating Instagram. Kung okay ba siya, no? Kasi yun ang isang basis ng HR, whether to hire or not to hire the applicant. All right. So why write an application letter or a cover letter, no? Number one reason is that to show your communication skills or your writing skills. Senior high school students, regardless of your course, regardless of your program, of your strand, of the kind of work that you are going to have in the future, there will come a time, no? There will come a point in your career, in your work, that you are going to write something. Maybe you are going to write a report. You are going to write the ingredients, no? You are going to write an instruction, no? Basta kahit anong writing, meron yan. So, in the assessment, one way of assessing your capability, no, your ability to write, is looking at your application letter. The other reason why you are going to write an application letter is to highlight the purpose of that letter and introduce the writer, introduce yourself to the reader. The third one is to give the reader an idea whether to continue reading the rest of the documents or not. That's why an application letter is called a cover letter, because you're going to, the possibility is you're going to submit many documents, no? Naka-folder yan, nakalagay sa isang folder, maraming mga documents, yung mga credentials naka-attach. Ang pinakaunang page na nakalagay doon ay yung inyong application letter, kaya you call that cover letter. Now, depende kung ang HR will continue reading the documents, no, the rest of the documents, nakadepende yan sa first page ng inyong mga series of documents. All right? So, ano ngayon ang suggested format, no, in writing an application letter? Or kahit anong letter, no? Kahit hindi lang application letter, senior high, no? Kahit ibang letter, kahit ibang documents. Now, you have their heading, no? Anong laman ng heading? Of course, your address. Tapos, date of writing, no? Like, ngayon, ano ngayon? April 22, okay? 2022, no? So, don't forget the date. Next up, next important part of the letter is the inside address, no? In the inside address, anong laman doon? You have the name of the addressee, the title, the position, the name of the organization, and the address. Do not forget, ito ha, remember, do not forget the name of the person. Kailangan meron talaga kayong pangalan. In case you don't have the name, you don't know the name, you don't know whom to address the letter, the best thing that you are going to do, senior high students, is you ask, you contact, you visit, no? Puntahan nyo muna ang company, magpunta muna kayo, mag-inquire kayo. You go straight to the HR office kung mag-a-apply kayo. Kasi ang HR office ang nag-a-process ng mga application documents, no? All right. And then you have their salutation, no? In your letter, remember that application letter is a formal type of communication. Since it's formal, therefore you have to be formal. The tone of your letter, the tone of your communication must be formal all throughout no, the letter, okay? So bawal ang dear Miss Santos, no? Unless magkakilala kayo ni Miss Santos, okay lang. Pero kung hindi kayo magkakilala, sabihin mo Miss Santos and then colon, okay? Miss Santos colon. Magsulat kayo ng letter, hindi kayo kilala nung pinadala nyo ng letter, huwag nyo lagyan ng dear para mas formal ang dating. Alright? Next, in your letter writing, pwede kayo, meron kayong tatlong paragraphs lang, no? Kasi nga, isang page lang naman yan, no? Huwag nyo damihan. So ano ang mga laman ng mga paragraphs na yon? Meron yun siya role. Merong importanteng contribution yung mga paragraphs na yon. Ang first paragraph is that you state how did you get to know the information about the job openings, no? And you mention your interest for the position. Importante malaman ngayon ng pinadalhan ninyo ng letter kung paano ninyo nalaman na merong job vacancy. Alright? Sa second paragraph ninyo ng inyong application letter, that's where you are going to describe your qualifications. Brief lang, no? Short. Briefly describe your qualifications. How are you going to do that? Kung may work experience kayo, isama ninyo na nakapagtrabaho kayo ng ganito, meron kayong internship, meron kayong exposure, and ano yung inyong characteristics, ano yung description sa inyo na connected doon sa requirement sa trabaho. Halimbawa, kung ang trabaho ay kailangan na isang team player person, no? Because you are going to work in a team, then therefore meron ka noon, then that's what you are going to highlight in the second paragraph because that is the requirement for the position. All right? Okay. Senior High, if you have questions or if you have something to say, you type, no, that one in the chat box, no? And in the closing paragraph, since you cannot tell everything about you, no, about your qualifications, about your potentials in the second paragraph then you try to open the opportunity for you to share many of your qualifications in the third paragraph. Para bang sa sinasabi mo na I have many things to share to you in person, no? And I'm willing to come for an interview. Para, alam mo yon, kung ako ang HR nun, ma-excite ako, magka-interest ako na tawagin ka for the next interview. Remember, Senior High, the purpose of your resume and the purpose of your application letter is for you to proceed to the next stage, which is the interview. Yan ang purpose bakit meron kayo application letter and resume, no? All right. And then close, no? Sincerely. Formal dapat din kayo, no? Sincerely, your name and then your signature. Do not forget your signature in your letter application. All right? Okay. Now I have here an example letter. This is how a sample application letter looks like. So the name of the addressee is here, the date is here. The name of the person is here, no? The title, the name of the organization, and the address. And then the opening, no? Mr. Baluran. Ito, first paragraph. Then you have there the second paragraph. The applicant talks about the experiences, no? The attributes, the qualifications. No, you can take a screenshot if you want, no? And then the third paragraph, sincerely, and then the name with signature. So that's how are you going to write a letter, application letter. Pwede nyo din ito magamit even if other types of letter, other types of communication, no? Okay, formal communication. Pwede din ganyan na format. Let's proceed to the resume. Now the resume details your qualification, all right? It's like a brochure, no? It's like a brochure that you are trying to market yourself, and the information about yourself are written in that brochure, no, in that resume. So kung ang employer, a potential employer, wants to find out more about you, that's why they have to read your resume. So that's how important the resume is. Okay? All right. So for new graduates, just like you senior high school, no, mag-graduate kayo, mag-apply kayo ng work, You can list your accomplishments in school kasi wala naman kayo work experience. You have not experienced any work at all, no? Do not worry about not having work-related accomplishments. You can pick out those school accomplishments that show responsibility, dependability, cooperative spirit, and the like, no? So, senior high, ang suggestion doon is that dapat kayo, if nasa school pa kayo, nag-aaral pa kayo, dapat hindi lang kayo pure and simple student, plain and simple student, no? Dapat you also have to engage, participate yourself, and engage yourself in various activities, no? Kung merong mga activities, school activities, competitions, seminars, community extension, whatever is that, participate. Because that is something na pwede ninyo madagdag sa inyong resume. Okay? Kung may mga seminars kayo attended just like today, maghingi kayo ng inyong certificate because it will help you when you will find jobs in the future, no? So I think dito, magbigay naman ang certificate ang University of Mindanao. So how are you going to write your resume? You start with your name, tapos address, tapos contact number and email address, no? Hindi pwede ngayon sa inyong generation, senior high, na wala pa kayong contact number at saka email address. Dapat meron na. Because that's the fastest, no? The easiest way for the potential employer to inform, to give you feedback on the status of your application. Okay? And then summary statement, work, or related experience, no? Kung halimbawa meron kayong internship, pag sa college kasi, no, required kasi lahat ng program, lalo na sa HRM and tourism, required talaga yung exposure, no? Required talaga yung on the job training. So once mag-apply na kayo ng work, meron talaga kayong masulat sa inyong resume. Yung inyong OJT, yun ang i-highlight ninyo sa inyong resume. Okay? And then you have their accomplishments and education. All right. So senior high, when you are going to write your resume, please take note of these 7 things. No, kung ako mag-evaluate, kung ako ang HR, magsulat kayo ng inyong resume, isipin ninyo na HR kayo at ano ang hahanapin ng HR, no, doon. So one is that, what can you do for me and do you have the skills I'm looking for? So it talks about the skills, the knowledge, the talents of the applicants. Kung kailangan mo mag-perform ng mga equipment, halimbawa sa HRM at saka sa tourism, lalo na sa HRM, ang daming mga kailangan gagawin, no? Sa dapat magaling kayong mga folding, sa hotel, something like that, di ba? So that is a highly competent course, discipline, no? So, importante, alam mo yon, no? Marunong ka kahit mag-arrange ng bed, okay? Mag-arrange ng room, di ba? So, yung mga ganon. Where have you worked before? Kung meron ka experience, that's what you mean by where have you worked before? Or is your experience relevant to my needs, no? Do you have the right education and credentials? What kind of person are you and where can I contact you? Okay? So, there are skills that you need to develop, generic skills, soft skills, regardless of course, kung anong discipline ka, anong kurso kunin mo, anong trabaho kunin mo in the future, ito yung mga skills na dapat ninyo i-develop, no? So I suggest senior high students, take note of this, no? You take a screenshot of this, and as you develop, no? As you journey in your studies after your senior high school, if you proceed to college, no, another years in college, try to take note of these skills that you need to develop because regardless of the work that you will have in the future, these are skills, these are very important skills that HR will be looking for, no, from the applicants. No, one is communication skills. So what do you mean by communication skills? When you say communication skills, it doesn't mean only the ability to speak in English, you know? It's the ability of the person to say something about a particular issue, a particular topic at hand. All right? Ibig sabihin nun, marunong ka mag-express sa sarili mo kung ano ang pinag-uusapan. If we're going to talk about, you know, your field of discipline like hospitality industry, we're going to talk about hospitality industry. Therefore, you can say something about hospitality industry. You are knowledgeable about hospitality industry and you can express yourself well. Okay, so that's what they mean by communication skills. No, the other one is problem solving, no? The ability to solve problem. If you're into the situation, how are you going to solve that? No, responsibility, pag magbigyan ka ng assignments, ibig sabihin nun, kaya mong gawin, kaya mo ma-deliver, no? And the like. So please take note of these skills. Now, how are you going to develop these skills? I already told you, senior high school, that while you're in school, make the most of your stay, you know, in school. I hope, I pray that we will go back to our old normal because I also believe that learning face-to-face is really different, no? Than learning only on online, pure online classes, no? I mean, you know, iba talaga yung, you know, you're in school and you will be exposed to the actual setting. Makita ninyo, tama ba? No, agree kayo doon? So iba talaga pag face-to-face ang classes, no? Social activities. Importante yung inyong pakipag-mingle, no? Yung inyong network of other people, friends, activities with friends. And I also suggest senior high students that ang inyong mga friends, hindi lang din pareho na edad ninyo, no? I suggest that you look for friends who are more mature than you are, who have achieved success in their career because you will learn from them, no? When you listen to them, for sure you will learn something from them, okay? Doing your hobbies, doing volunteer works, no? It will develop your sense of volunteerism and enhance your social skills, all right? Doing house chores will also help you improve your sense of responsibility, no? Hindi lang tayo palagi naghahawak sa ating mga gadgets, sa ating cellphone, nakimarites kung what's going on with our friends. But you know, we also have to do some house chores, no? And that's a sense of responsibility, okay? Now, how long should a resume be? 2 pages, not more than 2 pages, okay? Senior high, when you write your resume, wag sobra 2 pages kasi busy ang mga HR, okay? What should I include in my personal data? In general, avoid facts that may be used to discriminate against you, just like, you know, height, weight, religion. These are things that are not important in your application. So don't include them in your resume. Should you include your picture in your resume? I suggest that no picture. Unless you are applying as a modeling, as a model, no. I mean, no need, no? No need. Well, for the tourism industry, maybe the our speaker from the tourism industry may say something about that, no? Because that's sometimes important, especially if you are applying for airline industry. I think airline industry requires height, no? And you know, you must possess a good personality, a pleasing personality. So there are exemptions, no? There are a few exemptions with regards to this, but generally that's how it is, no? So this is a sample resume. Then you have there the name, summary statement, no? Objective, skills, education, experience, okay? Affiliations, honors and awards, seminars, and then character reference. So that's a sample resume. You see, it's just a one-page resume, but the most important information that the employer will be looking for from the applicant are already there in that one-page resume, okay? Now let's proceed to the most tension-filled part of your application, no? All right? You will agree with me if I would say that it's the most tension-filled moment. Yeah, just like in a beauty contest, you will notice sometimes that some candidates cannot respond to questions, no? I mean, it's not probably that they do not know, but it's a feeling that it's like there are dinosaurs and crocodiles in your stomach that's fighting with each other. That's why it's a tension-filled moment, all right? Okay, it's the dreaded moment. It's a dreaded part of your application. So how are you going to prepare? How are you going to ace in your job interview? You know, senior high, there is a book published by Sancho entitled Art of War. Noon kasi, in the primitive time, in the ancient times in China, and not only in China, you know, uso kasi yung mga gyera-gyera, di ba ganyan? And Sancho published a book about Art of War, the winning style, the art, the style of winning the art of war. I mean, the winning in the war. In short, it's a book about strategy, no? And according to Sancho, one of the best strategies for you to win in a war is preparation, winning half the battle. And that Sancho book, Art of War, has been published in many disciplines and has been applied in many disciplines, no? So it's all about strategy. So what will be your best strategy for you to ace, no? For you to be ahead compared to the other applicants, no? If you're in a beauty contest, what will be your best, you know, strategy? So according to Sancho, is that preparation. You have to prepare. And why is it that job interview is the deciding factor? Because it's the final stage of the screening. And just like in a beauty contest, you know, in the Miss World, in the Miss Universe, whatever beauty competition is that, you've noticed that the last part of this competition is the Q&A, the question and answer, right? And before they determine the winner, diba, there's a question and answer, and they will just, you know, rate and determine who deserves the crown based from the last question and answer. So just like in a job application process, the interview is the deciding factor. They will decide who will be hired for the position based on the performance of the applicants in the job interview. The applicant that will be hired may not necessarily be the most qualified, but the fact that he's the best applicant based on the interview performance, therefore, he will be hired or she will be hired. Why is that so? Because there's an impression that how an applicant behaves during the interview is often an indicator of how they will perform, no? So nakikita natin, nakikita ng mga HR, nakikita ng mga evaluator, that kung paano ka mag-perform during job interview, the same performance you will deliver, no? When you will be hired for the position. And we want confident applicant, no? And if you are not confident, it means that you are giving an impression that you cannot perform the job. So, sinasabi dito that the better prepared you are, the less nervous you will feel and the more confident you will appear, no? The more you know about the purpose of the interview and the organization, the better your response to the questions. So, senior high students, isipin ninyo palagi that job interview is not only about HR and interviewer asking about your qualifications, but they want to know your greater perspective, no? Your better understanding on the requirement of the position and of the company. Naintindihan ninyo ako, no? Ibig sabihin nun, malawak ang understanding ko, malawak ang alam ko about the requirement of the position. Alam na alam ko to, no? So that's why when you study, when you pursue in college, that's very crucial because, you know, going to a college is a formal way of learning something, no? It's the most formal way of preparing you for your future career, all right? Hindi pwede ikaw magtrabaho sa isang gusto mo na career kung wala kang formal training for that, all right? So that is why you really have to pursue to college, especially if you have, you know, better ambition, better goal, okay, deeper objective for your career and for yourself, no? Pag-isipan niyo talaga yan kasi ang buhay ng tao, proseso yan, no? So nasa stage kayo na you are preparing yourself for the future, okay? You are preparing yourself for the future. So, pag once magiging successful na kayo, then that's the time also that you will settle down, no? You will think of your family, you will think of you know, having your children and your family, no, a family of your own. But this time, dapat hindi muna yun ang iniisip ninyo. Yung time na ito, yun pa ang inyong iniisipin dapat is how are you going to prepare your career? Because it's going to be a long-lasting decision. Now, kung hindi ninyo yan paghandaan ng sarili ninyo, there will come a point in your life na pagsisihan ninyo yan dahil you will never go back to that stage again. You know what I mean? So this stage of your life, you are going to prepare for your future. Okay? So let's go back to the interview. Doing an interview, well, what the employers generally are looking for, why there's an interview, number one is that, well, they want to know whether you can perform the job. Can you do the job? So the question will all about be your skills, your talents, your competencies, and your abilities. No? The other one is, will you do the job? So it's all about the interest, your motivation, and your right values to work. So I already mentioned about, you know, what the interviewer is looking for is the whole perspective, no? The greater perspective, whether you have a wider understanding on the requirement and expectation of the position, okay? So what are some of the sample interview questions, no, that will be raised during job interview? Because as I said, na ang best strategy ninyo is you have to prepare, and that the questions in job interviews are the same over and over again, no? So number one is that, tell me something about yourself. So you introduce yourself in such a way that you highlight your what? Your characteristics, what qualifies you, and what makes you the perfect candidate for the job, no? What's best, what qualities you have, what attributes that you possess, what are your characteristics, what are your experiences with regards to the position? No, that's what you are going to do when you will be asked to introduce yourself, no? Okay. What do you know about our company? And remember, senior high students, that if you are applying for jobs, that means that you want to have an engaging relationship with the organization, with the company. So just like, you know, going into a romantic relationship, diba? Before going into a romantic relationship, you really have to identify and know and investigate whether that person that you like shares the same interest and passion as you, no, diba? Kung meron ba kayong mga commonalities or similarities, di ba? So the same thing, if you're going to apply in a company, no, ititest ngayon ng HR, ng interviewer, kung meron ka bang alam about our company. So the best thing that you can do is that you have to do research about the company, about its product and services, so that you can connect the culture, no, the culture of the organization, the purpose of the organization, the intention of the organization with your philosophy statement, with your philosophy in life. No? Okay? All right. Third, what is your greatest weakness? No? Why this question will be asked during interview? Ito, senior high students, gusto lang i-test kayo ng HR kung if you have recognized the reality that no one is perfect. So hindi ka pwede magsagot sa question na ito that, you know, I don't have any weakness. Kasi wala talaga tao na hindi perfect. We are not perfect, no? We are made not to be perfect, all right? There are things that are missing in us, no? And what is the importance about this question? Well, aside from, if I am the HR, I want to know whether you acknowledge the reality that you are not perfect. I also want to know that if you have your weakness, how do you overcome that weakness? And how do you turn that weakness into something positive? You know what I mean? So halimbawa ako, ang weakness ko is that I'm an impatient person. No, I really don't like to stuck in a traffic. So impatient ako, ayoko ma-stuck ako sa traffic, no? Na-stuck ako sa traffic. So ako, ang ginagawa ko is that maaga ako nagabiyahe from my house to my office para hindi ako mainto sa traffic. Okay? So ang punto ko dito is that if you have weakness, you should know how to overcome your weakness. No? Do you have any question? So ito, senior high, when you're in a job interview, even attending seminars just like this, no? Do not let the seminar ends or do not let the interview ends without you asking any question. Why? Because it will give an impression to the speaker or to the interviewer that you are not interested. You are just there for compliance purposes because you have not asked any question. Okay? Imposible naman wala ka talaga question, no? Unless may problema ka sa connection, right? Just like right now. Or nagmamadali ka, di ba? Pero meron ka talagang question. Meron ka talagang gustong i-clarify. Okay? Because the moment that you raise questions, it will really give an impression that you are really interested. No? Okay. What can you contribute most to our organization? Hala, naadi amutan, may hong kakay contribute man. Tagpila man ang amutan. No, it's not. That question is really asking your better perspective of if you will be given the chance to work in the company, then how can you help us? No, it's not only about you that, you know, once, kasi kailangan mo talaga ng trabaho, kailangan mo ng sweldo. Aside from that, then what? How are you going to, you know, share your talents and your abilities in return once you will be hired? No? Okay. Now, there is an interview done to all members of the PMAP. Ito yung mga HR managers. This is an organization of HR managers in the country. They were asked questions like, what are the common interview mistakes of the job applicants, no? And these are the list, no? So please take note of this. Don't do this when you're in a job interview because it's a big no-no, no? Like answering cell phone or texting, dressing inappropriately, appearing disinterested, arrogant, unprepared, no, chewing gum, not providing specific answers, and not asking good questions, no. So please take note of this. Don't do this when you're in a job interview. Okay. Now, last topic. It's all about social media etiquette. I already mentioned that many HR, they will do background investigation, and if they want to know more about the applicant. Kahit good na yan sa inyo, di ba? Kung gusto mo mag-stalk, di ba? I-stalk naman ninyo ang social media account sa tao na gusto ninyo i-stalk, right? Para mahibaon ninyo, uy, unsa din niya mga likes, unsa din mga gusto ani niya, di ba? Mga anak man, no? Same thing rapod na, no? So, ang HR, pag once magka-interest na sila sa inyo, ila lang nang tanaw ng inyo ha mga social media, okay? So, that's why, take note of this, no? Number one, do not write negative posts. Okay? Do not write negative posts. Do not share. Do not show negative emotions in your social media account. No? Okay? Do not write your discontentment. It does not mean that you have a social media account. Everything that you feel, you post that. All right? It's not so professional. Okay? It will lessen the professionalism in you, senior high school students. All right? Okay. The second one is ungrammatical posts or use of derogatory language, no? Remember that we're checking. If I'm HR, I'm checking how is this person doing in her or his social media account. And if I find some ungrammatical post, you are giving an impression that you are careless, diba? You don't check your work, diba? So if you are like that, therefore, kung i-hire kita, the same thing, no? I-submit mo lang, hindi mo siya i-review. All right? So, check your post before hitting the final button, the upload button. And third, make your posts all about you. Because it's a social media account, you know? Just like TikTok, my first impression of TikTok was that ikaw ra kay magsimang sayo-sayaw, makitaan man ako, sige sayo-sayaw, kanta-kanta, no? I mean, di ba? It's a social media account. It's a social media platform. What does it mean? If all your posts are all about you are giving an impression that you want the limelight, no? Always thrown at you. So mauna siya ang ginamin ana, no? So that is why, as much as possible, wag. Okay? Maybe what you can do is that if you have watched a new series, no, and then you have review, you have you have interpretation, no, then that's what you can post, no, or that if you have read a book, right, just like that, then you, if you have review of the newly read book, no, then post that in the social media, no. Although itong mga topic na ganyan, hindi siya masyado nila like. But, you know, if you're going to do that, malalaman mo kung sino yung mga friends mo sa social media with substance. No? Okay? All right. As I said, senior high students, you start acting like you're a professional. No? Okay? I think that's all. So I hope that you learned something from my talk. Thank you very much. I'll turn over the virtual floor to Benji.
All right. Thank you so much, Sir Ray, for those inputs with regards to the pre-employment requirements. Do you have, may we ask our participants if you have questions? You may chat it, no, on the chat box, and so that you could recognize. Or if you want to talk, no, you can just raise your hand so that we can allow you to unmute, no, yourself. Meron ba? Questions? Wala? Are you sure?
Wala ata silang questions. So sige, thank you very much. And
all right,
so advance congratulations to our senior high school students for your future graduation.
Yes, sir. So thank you so much, sir, no, for those inputs with regards to pre-employment requirements. All right. So as I have mentioned a while ago, no, after our session, we're going to have our a sort of quiz, all right? And then, of course, this quiz, no, of course, has a prize, all right? So once you will be the winner, no, of this online quiz, now you will get a 100 peso load or a GCash, all right? So are you excited for that? Okay, I know you're excited kayo niyan. All right, so please go to menti.com and then write your full name and also the code 73265913, no, so that you can join our online quiz. Okay, again, go to menti.com, write your full name, and also write the code, no, so that you can join our quiz. All right, ayun. So we are 80 plus, no, here on Zoom, and then meron din tayo mga participants na nandun ngayon sa YouTube. So let's just wait for them. No, kasi late, no, ng mga ilang seconds, no, yung YouTube. Ayan. So those students who are in the YouTube, so you can also join. Please go to menti.com and then you, the code is 73265913. So 73265913. So it's in the chat box right now. Ayan. So, dali, pasok na, pasok. Ayan. So, we have 7 na, 8. So, I think, no, our students also here in YouTube, kaya nakapasok na din. So, ayan, go, go, go. So, again, the price is... is 100 pesos na load. All right. Sige, we will wait for you, Laurel. Ayan. Sige, go, go, go. Pasok. 73265913 is the code. Don't forget to write your name so that we could recognize you later. Ayan. Go, go, go. Na, keep joining. Ayan. So I think, no, we can start, no, our quiz. Sige, let's go. So habol, habol lang iba. Go. Sige. So you go to menti.com, no, do not write it on our chat box. So have another kuan, like you go to the Safari ba or Google Chrome and then you search for menti.com. Ayan. Sige, let's go. Let's start. Ayan. Answer fast to get more points. Here's the first question. How long the ideal resume should be? Look at your phone and then click the right answer. Okay, 1 to 2 pages, 4 to 5 pages, or it depends on the job you're applying. 7 seconds to answer. 3, 2, 1, and time's up. Tingnan natin. Most of you says it's 1 to 2 pages, and that is correct. So let's see who's our top one for this question. Ayan. So we have Athena, Mary Cecil, Kyle, and Mac Lawrence Comendador. Ayan. So yun yung top 5 natin. And we also have Gar Joy, Salta. Okay. So we still have 4 questions. Let's go. Let's have the second question. Answer fast to get more points. Here we go. The objective of the resume is for the applicant to get hired. Is it true or false? Right. So let's see. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, let's see. Saan ang mas madaming answer? Most of you says it's true, but the correct answer is false. Alright, dalawa lang yung nakatama. Because the objective of the resume is for the applicant to get an interview. Interview muna. Ayan. So, let's see. Sino itong dalawa? And I think it's Athena and Mary Cecil. Ayan. So, fastest dito sa question si Athena. Alright, okay. Kaya pa yan. We still have 3 questions. Alright, go, go, go. So, answer fast to get more points. Here's the number 3 question. In hiring process, the best applicant gets the job. Is it true or false? Ayan. So, somehow related to the 2nd question. Sige nga. Let's see kung na-remember niyo kanina. 2, 1, time's up. Let's see kung saan mas madami. Madami pa din sa true, but the correct answer is false. So in hiring process, the best interview gets the job. Ayan. Sige. Let's see. Who's on the leaderboard? Will it still be Athena? Or madeslodge na siya? Parang. Alright, the fastest here is Mary Cecil. That's why si Mary Cecil na ang top 1 natin. 2nd si Athena, Mac Lawrence, Charlie, Jasaline, gaya pa yan. Ayan. We still have 2 questions. And others, go, go, go. Pas-pas dapat ang pag-click. 4 of 5. Here's the 4th question. Which of the following should not be in a resume? Look at your phone. Answer. What's your answer? Contact number, education, height, and religion. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time's up. Madami sa height and religion, and you are correct. Ayan. So let's see kung Mary Cecil pa din on the top or Athena. Gusto niyang kunin ang spot. Okay, still Mary Cecil on the 1st. 2nd si Athena, though fastest si Athena. Kaya pa yan. Ayan. Sige, last question. Let's see kung ang panalo na ba talaga is si Mary Cecil. Alright. During the interview, an applicant should not ask any question to the interviewer. Is it true or false? Okay. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time's up. Most of you says it's false and that is correct. Now, let's see kung si Mary Cecil na ba ang ating winner or merong someone no, from the ano, participants na manalo. Let's go. Dun, 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 dun. And our winner is... All right. It's Mary Cecil. Okay, congratulations, Mary Cecil. So please chat your number, no, so that we can give your prize, no, which is 100 pesos na load. All right. Again, congratulations. So, ayan. So we're done with our first topic, the pre-employment requirements, and hopefully you get all those information. Ayan. So sino yung nanalo kanina? Please write your number here sa ating chat box or daka na sa YouTube ka. So lagay mo lang. So congratulations. All right. So we're done with pre-employment requirements, and now let's go to our second topic. And I believe you're excited for this. No, most of you who joined our webinar this afternoon are from the TVL and also the GAS. And so this afternoon, let us discover what's in store for hospitality and tourism students. No, or who would like to be part of the hospitality and tourism industry? Okay, so we will be tackling more of immersion practices and career opportunities. So listen very carefully, because after this, we'll still have another quiz. All right. And for us to help us discover what's in store for hospitality and tourism industry for you guys, we have together with us this afternoon is the program coordinator or the program head of tourism management here in the University of Mindanao, Professor Clarence Joy D. Alcaraz. Ma'am?
Yes, good afternoon, Sir Benj. Good afternoon to all senior high school students. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you are.
Okay, so let me share my screen. All right, Sir Benj, is it in full screen already?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you for confirming, sir. So to begin with, let me greet everyone. Mabuhay ug madayaw. And for this afternoon, let me introduce myself. I am one of the faculty of the tourism management here at UM Main, Davao City. And for this afternoon, I am tasked to share to you what's in store with regards with the program that we are offering here in our college here at University of Mindanao. So we will discover this afternoon majority of the details and programs offered in hospitality and tourism. And I will highlight as well the immersion practices and career opportunities. So let's begin. So before we start, I would like to highlight this official greeting. So if you are working or if you are enrolled in BS Hospitality Management and Tourism Management programs, this is our official greeting. No, we use Mabuhay ug Madayaw. With this greeting, this will highlight the Filipino brands of service that we have in our industry, since we all know that Mabuhay means long live. And it is a word that reflects Filipino hospitality, culture, and heritage. And the right way to do that, I want to share it to the senior high school students, is you will place your right hand to your chest. When you say Mabuhay, then you will bow down your head. And then from the word, using the word Madayaw is Mabuhay and Madayaw, you will have this action. Now, if you will greet your guests, say for example, when you welcome guests to the airport or to the hotel. So this is our official greeting. So may I request our participants to unmute and say Mabuhay ug Madayaw? Is it possible?
Mabuhay and Madayaw.
Okay, thank you very much. So upon hearing that, if you are the tourist, if you are the guest of the hotel, probably you will feel the warmth of Filipino hospitality. So to start with, I'm going to explain to you the outline of my presentation and discussion. For this afternoon, I am going to discuss the program offering, competencies, and the career and job opportunities in hospitality and tourism management programs. So in the picture, I believe some of the renowned people, no, around the globe. No? I know that you're familiar with this famous chef, no, Gordon Ramsay, and if you are the one who loves to work and at the same time you can travel, then this is the best, no, program for you, no, working in the hospitality and tourism industry. So if you're still wondering right now what track or what program you want to take or to achieve, no, as your dream course, if you have this in mind, you're right, especially right now that you are a senior high school students and you're still deciding, no, what course will fit to your skill or to your character. The tourism and hospitality industry is, we all know that this is considered as the fastest growing industry in the world. And tourism industry is considered also as the largest industry. And everywhere, no, if you will visit different places, no, not only in the world, but here in the Philippines and in Davao region, looking to the left and right, no, you can see a lot of hotels. No, there are also popping up attractions, no, and there are beaches. No, there are numerous beaches and attractions na nakikita natin posted on the social media, and through that, no, we can conclude that there's really an opportunity, no, and a future, no, for hospitality and tourism industry. That's why right now, no, I am going to encourage everyone to choose this course, no, to choose and enroll BS Hospitality Management and Tourism Management. So if you're dreaming to work on an airline industry, and not only on airline, but also cruise line industry and biggest hotels, attractions, theme park around the globe, then this is the answer to your dream, no? To enroll in BS Hospitality Management and Tourism Management. So I hope my audio is clear. So first thing first is let me highlight to you, no, the advantages in enrolling in hospitality and tourism industry. So with so many different career avenues available, it can be a particular challenging task, no, to try and figure out which career path you should take. So if you're looking for a career in which you can grow and your career can grow vertically, no, as well as horizontally, then you should definitely consider career opportunities in hospitality and tourism. So you can get a lot of chance to meet new faces, no? So number one is it is a powerful industry since tourism is the world's largest and fastest growing industry in the world. Number two is if you're enrolled in these two programs, the environment is diverse and dynamic, no? You get to know a lot of people, a lot of culture, not only Filipinos, but you're going to meet a lot of culture, like from ASEAN, from European or even Western culture. So there's a lot of variety of career paths. And aside from that, it's flexible, no? It offers many possibilities for flexible schedule and also seasonal job. So I'm going to share a lot of example later that they're working on an airline and cruise line, but during their break time, they can visit, no, famous attractions because there are times that they visit European countries, and kung break nila or during off, no, off nila or holiday, they can visit, no, and travel at the same time during work. So sino, anong course ba naman ang magbibigay sa inyo ng ganyang opportunity? And aside from that, no, it's a great atmosphere, no? The atmosphere is friendly and vibrant, people working together to satisfy and delight customer, because our main goal, no, especially because I am a graduate of BS Tourism Management at the year of 2012, and I graduated from University of Mindanao, and I am proud that I am a graduate of BS Tourism because the University of Mindanao also inculcated a lot of knowledge. And if you will enroll in hospitality and tourism management, you get to know what are the standard and excellent, no, service, no, people, yung mga tourists na kailangan nila. So the main goal is to satisfy the needs and wants of our guests, of our tourists, and of our customers. So yan. And great perks. Yes, this is the reason. This is the number five reason, because it offers highly competitive pay and compensation. Aside from the salary that you will get, you can get also a lot of tip, not to your tourists and customers. If you're working in the hotel or if you're a tour guide. So it offers a lot of great perks. And for number six, easy entry and advancement. No? The entry-level job opportunities, especially for ambitious and dedicated workers, there are also possibilities of quick promotion, no? Here on hospitality and tourism industry. And there are endless opportunities, possibility to combine work with travel and meet new challenges. And it's global, no? You'll meet a lot of people around the world. And it's a creative industry. There is always a way to make your service more enjoyable for your customers. And for number 10 is you make people's day, because our service on this industry are intangible services. Now, you know what's intangible? These are the service na hindi natin nahahawakan. No, we cannot buy, but this is through experience. No, these are the services that we get from the tour guide, from the flight attendant, no, from the pilot, from the front desk of a hotel. So yun yung product natin in hospitality and tourism industry. So I am assuming right now, no, that you are already a student of hospitality and tourism management programs. So let's try to be specific. No, I will try to be specific. I will explain each program. No, what is hospitality management and what is tourism management? I believe that in senior high school, this is under TVL track, and the strand is home economics. No, right? The tourism and hospitality management. But what is the definition of hospitality management, no, as a bachelor degree course in college? Bachelor of Science in Hospitality Management is a four-year degree program that delivers education to people who are interested to build a career and leisure industry involving planning, development, implementation, and control of culinary and accommodation belting operations. So this program professionally trains and equips students with competencies. So we will find out later what are those competencies needed, no, if you want to be a hospitality management student. Some of that is you need a lot of skills on executing tasks on food production and accommodations operating on food and beverage service operations. So this program prepares students not to become highly competent hospitality management practitioners, serving their constituents and those in allied professions with demonstrating high ethical and moral standards and the utmost and technical competence. Because especially here in UM or in this program, you are trained not as a back of the house, but you are trained to be a frontliner. You are trained to be manager, supervisor, no, globally. So we would try our best to instill the global skills, no, needed on the present time. So I will discuss also what are the objectives, no, of the program under hospitality management. So first one is if you're enrolled in this program, you are expected to demonstrate the abilities of hospitality professionals that can work in diverse cross-cultural setting, because we know that people around the world have different preferences, no? They have different perspective, iba't iba ang kanilang mga nature of demands. So if you are working on hospitality industry, you really need to meet, no, the demands, the needs of this different target market. So there are people na, because there are types of tourists, no, there are types of customer. There are customer na ayaw nila na VIP ang treatment sa kanila, but there are also customer, no, or a guest in the hotel that needs high level of service, no? So iba-iba. So we really need to adjust our service, no, depending on the nature of the target market. So also, you're expected to demonstrate leadership, interpersonal communication, collaborative, and cultural competence. And aside from that, no, exhibit high sense of ethical responsibility and engage in research and continuing professional development. Now, what are the competencies, no, that you need to develop if you will enroll in hospitality management? So the following are food and beverage, no? And I believe that during your senior high, there are also opportunity that you are, that this is a requirement that you take this one in TESDA as an NC2 competency. So my NC2 and food and beverage, meron ding NC3, no? Housekeeping, front office, cookery, barista, and events management. So these are the top six competencies that you need to develop if you will enroll in BS Hospitality Management. So food and beverage, kasali na dito ang skirting, table napkin folding, and banquet setup, no? And aside from that, how will you make the menu delicious, aside from the taste, is how presentable is the plating of the food and how will you carry the food to the customer. So yan, matututunan niyo yan. And for housekeeping naman, this is concerned more on the cleanliness and the organization of the rooms. There are different types of rooms of the hotel. So may mga standards na sinusunod. And for front office naman, is here for this competency is tuturuan kayo ng room audit na standards and skills as well, no, how to book the guest to a specific hotel using software system, no, so kasi hindi natin gagamitin na ang manual, so we'll use the software system, no, using a computer, so tuturuan kayo. And for cookery, it's more on preparations of the food. There are different types of cuisines, right? Not only Filipino dish, but you'll be learning a different array and list of different cuisines, no, Western, Asian food, yun yung mga Thai, Chinese, so tuturuan kayo with the different cuisines, no, in cookery. And for barista, how to prepare coffee, no? There are different types of coffee drinks like cappuccino and paano nyo lalagyan ng art. So you'll be learning that one. And also events management. And for the student outcome, no, these are the expected student outcome if you will enroll in BS Hospitality Management. Produce food products and services complying with enterprise standards. Lalo na ngayon that in Department of Tourism, we are meticulous on the food that we produce sa business, like ano ba siya, accredited ba siya ng DOT ang establishment or halal food ba siya. So tuturuan kayo, no, to distinguish and to determine the different standards on food products and services. You will also apply management skills in food and beverage and operation. You'll also expected to perform and provide full guest service for front office. So yun yung gimension ko kanina, no, this is related, student outcome is related to the competencies of hospitality management. So kasali na dito ang front office, perform and maintain various housekeeping services, plan and implement, no, so this is an error, plans and implement a risk management program, provide food and beverage service and manage the operation seamlessly. Plans, organize, implement, and evaluate MICE activities. So what is MICE pala? No? So I would like to give to you the definition of MICE. MICE stands for meetings, I, incentive, C, convention, and E, exhibit. So I hope that you will take note that one kasi baka later may pa-quiz tayo. So meeting, incentive, convention and exhibit, no? So this MICE is very important, no, in planning and in developing events, no, events management. So ito yon, meetings, incentives, convention and exhibit. And aside from that, this is very important, the importance of conducting research, no, in tourism and hospitality field. Now, what are the career opportunities for hospitality management? So if you are a graduate of hospitality management, you can work in a cruise line, in a hotel, in the academe, or even on different establishments, no, here in the Philippines or in the globe. So these are the possible positions that you can get, no, because we are, but the example are concentrated on the hotel position. So you can be a general manager, a resident manager, food and beverage director, banquet director, food and beverage outlet manager, restaurant manager or supervisor, outlet manager, and the rest, no? The rest are the possible career or job position na pwede nyo, na pwedeng ma-hire kayo after if you are a graduate of this program. So yan. And since the program includes business-related courses, no, this is a trivia that a BS in hospitality management graduate may also be a sales representative, commercial account specialist, trainee group consultant, marketing analyst, no, administrative assistant, sales and marketing manager. So there are a array of opportunity, no, awaits, no, if you are a graduate of BS Hospitality Management. But the main workplace, no, for you is the hotel, the big hotels, no, not only here in our region, but in the Philippines, because there are a lot of hotels right now in the Philippines, and some of them are five-star hotels. No, sa Davao, we have Seda Hotel, we have Park Inn Hotel, no, those are the hotel na five-star ang kanilang standard. We also have, pero as of the moment, no, because of the COVID-19 and pandemic, nag-close ang famous hotel, which is Marco Polo in Davao City. But I believe that since we are gradually restarting tourism, no, I know that hindi na matatagalan, but the hotel, no, majority of the hotels na nag-close during pandemic, and the hotel, no, establishment, not only hotels but tourism business establishment ay mag-bounce back na sila. No, we are looking forward for that for the year 2022 and 2023. So yeah, those are the careers, no, awaits, no, if you are in the hospitality management. And I would like just to encourage you with this, no, if you are a graduate of this program, considering that hotel management job assures money, satisfaction, security, and growth, ito yung range ng salary ninyo. And naka-enlist dito ang 7, no, we have best jobs for hospitality management, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and the range of the salary and the average. And what are the countries, no, hiring, top countries hiring hospitality management graduates? Ito Australia, Luxembourg, New Zealand, France, Netherlands, Ireland, Belgium. We have Germany, United Kingdom, Canada, Japan, United States, South Korea, and Slovenia. No, so yan yung top 14 countries hiring hospitality management jobs, no, in the world. So I hope that through that, they'll be able to realize and decide right now that you will pursue, no, your education in choosing this program, hospitality management. And I just like to highlight, no, the UM, no, UM Student Life and Immersion Practices under Hospitality Management Program. So there, as I have shared on the screen, no, these are the students during pre-COVID time ito, yung hindi pa nangyari ang pandemic, no, when students are the one who prepared their food and they invited their parents, no. So this is also an amazing and heartwarming opportunity for students, no, na sila yung nagluto ng pagkain and nag-set up sa table, and they invited their parents na as their official guests, no. So per student, ang kanilang guest ay ang kanilang parents. So that is also a heartwarming event and activity na nangyari during the activities and banquet set up subject. We also have bartending and in barista naman, no, nag-prepare sila ng drinks for their guests. And this one naman ay during their front office seminar. So nangyari ito during pre-COVID time, hindi pa nangyari ang pandemic. But in the new normal, no, during COVID-19, UM doesn't stop, no, we still engage our students on these activities virtual, and nangyari yon when we invited a lot of industry practitioners from different hotels, no, in the Philippines, nag-speaker sila, and nagkaroon tayo ng virtual immersion. So during their immersion and OJT program pre-COVID time, we send students to Seda Hotel in Davao, and meron din kaming programs na students are given the chance to have their OJT in domestic, no, Astoria Hotel in Boracay and Palawan. In the pictures, UM student, no, these are our student from Hospitality Management Program, and ito yung OJT namin that sinend namin sila sa Boracay and Palawan during their OJT and immersion. And this is the time when we invited chef, no, expert chef to be here at UM on site to teach students about food plating and the concepts of standards of product, food, product services. So, yan. So during the in-house hotel training laboratory immersion. Okay, so some of the photos, no, happened during the immersion. And aside from that, no, nakikita nyo on screen are the UM, no, UM students here from Matina when they have their USA Cultural Exchange Program. So yan, when you are enrolled in this program, you get the chance to travel, no, even if you're still a student during your OJT, because you have an option to have your OJT at Nevada, Connecticut, Wisconsin, California. So there are different states, no, in the US where we send our students, no, during their immersion program. So yan. These are the proof, no, that our students are globally competitive, no, here at the University of Mindanao. So yan, mga students natin, ito sila, and right now they are already a graduate of BS Hospitality Management and Tourism Management Program. So now, next one is Bachelor of Science in Tourism Management. So here in the picture, no, you can see me in the picture. These are my previous students, no, and right now they are already a graduate of BS Tourism Management. So what is tourism management? This is also a four-year degree program that delivers education to people who are interested to build a career in travel and leisure industry, involving tourism planning, development, implementation, and control management functions. So BSTM program professionally trains and equips students with competencies that needed on the airline industry, on the Department of Tourism, on cruise lines, and also on the hotel and travel and tour establishment. So this program will prepare students to become highly competent in tourism management practitioners, serving constituents and those and allied profession with while demonstrating, you know, high ethical and moral standards and the utmost of technical competence. So what are the program educational objectives, no, in tourism management? So you are expected, no, students enroll in this program are expected to demonstrate knowledge of tourism industry, local products and services. So I know that you have heard somebody that if you are enrolled in tourism management, there's no math. No, diyan na lang kami kasi walang math, but actually there's math in this course. Aside from that, I'll get an example. Aside from memorizing the Philippine map, memorizing the world map, you'll get to also know how to compute the different prices. No, if you will create an itinerary, no, an itinerary for local, domestic, and international. And aside from that, you'll need to familiarize the codes, the airport codes, the city codes. So there's a lot of theories, no, computations na mangyayari also in tourism management course. And aside from that, ng mga na-mention ko, you need also to be familiar on interpreting and apply relevant laws related to tourism industry, observe and perform risk mitigation activities, utilize information technology, manage and market a service-oriented business organization, demonstrate managerial skills in a service-oriented organization, and utilize various communications. Since in this course, you need to pass the subject, no, Nihongo subject, that's one of the foreign language as part of the curriculum, that you can speak not only English and Filipino, but also a foreign language. So we are training students also to be interpreter, but what we highlight on the curriculum is the Nihongo language. So yeah. And what are the competencies in this course? Tourism promotion, because you will promote, no, the Philippines. We have tagline, it's more fun in the Philippines. So you are trained here to be a tour guide as well, no? So yan yung isa sa mga competencies, to be a good tour guide. Tour and travel services, tuturuan kayo how to book airline ticket, cruise line ticket, how to check in guest to a certain hotel. So yeah, that's more on airline booking and ticketing services. Front office, no, so that's GDS, airline booking and ticketing. And aside from that, same with hospitality management, students are also trained to be events leaders, no, they are event specialists because they need to have this skills on events management. When you say events management, what are the events expected? Hindi ito birthday or wedding, but the events that I'm talking about are conventions, exhibit, no, gaya ng Olympics, no, so yan yung mga big events, no, related to tourism and hospitality industry. And ano yung mga student outcomes, no, expected if you are a tourism student? Plans, implement and monitor tours and sales activities, because per course you have the chance to travel not only local, domestic, but also international. So yeah, research, plan and conduct various tour guiding activities, develop appropriate marketing programs and arrange required travel experience, plan, organize, implement and evaluate MICE activities, plan, develop, and evaluate tourism sites and attractions, and also the importance of conducting research in the hospitality and tourism field. So here at the University of Mindanao, I am proud to say that we are offering internship and immersion practices, US Work and Travel Program. Before COVID, 3 months of campus internship, both national and local, in-house hotel training, laboratory immersion, and flexible industry practicum program during COVID-19. Yung gibawal ang pag-travel, no, during travel restriction, we have this flexible industry practicum program. So what are the tourism management career opportunities? So here are the possible career that you can choose, no, when you are a graduate of BS Tourism Management. And the main workplace for this career are hotels, airline, no, because majority of our graduates became a flight attendant in Philippine Airlines, Cebu Pacific, Air Asia, and international airline companies. So yan. You can also be a travel photographer, travel writer. So yan. And the organization's link to tourism management is the Department of Tourism, Tourism Promotions Board, United Nations World Tourism Organizations, and other international organizations. Also, tour guide, no, pwede kang mag-open ng own travel agency mo, no, under this program. And also, no, kagaya ng HM, the program includes business-related courses under this career opportunities and position. And for the salary, no, top we have five job title: tourism information officer, director in tourism, tourism analyst, corporate tourism, and tourism operation. But if you're a graduate also of this program, you can also be a professor. You can also teach in the academe and university. Okay, just like me. Now, I want to share, no, the USA work and travel experience of our hospitality and tourism management students. So let's watch this video. Tourism management students Camille and Vien, and this is the sum up of their experience during USA work and travel program. All right, so okay, and aside from sending our students to abroad for their OJT and immersion, we send students also in the airport, in Davao International Airport, to work with the flight attendants, no, in Philippine Airlines. So also this is our students during their practicum and immersion at Philippine Airlines. No, as you can see, they have experience to work with the crew in PAL and at the same time to the pilot of Philippine Airlines, also in Air Asia. And we send students also not only in Davao International Airport, but also domestic airports like Clark International Airport in Pampanga. And they work together with the cabin crew on the Emirates, no? Emirates cabin crew and team. So yan. And Omni Aviation as well. Department of Tourism. Nag-OJT din ang mga students from UM Tourism, City Tourism Operations Office. So during the new normal, if you will ask me what happened when there are lockdowns and travel restrictions, do we still continue this privilege that we offer to our students? Yes. So in the new normal, we shifted to offer flexible industry practicum virtually. So still our students continue, no, hindi tayo nag-stop in providing opportunities for students for their immersion. So we have flexible industry practicum wherein students will enroll online and they have different modules to accomplish, no? So 600 hours ito and lahat ng kanilang mga activities they use online platform. And we offer alternative online OJT program for both programs, no, for hospitality management and tourism management programs. And I just want to share that last 2021, also our students, no, third year students, tourism management students, Kyla Nina Baze and Rhea Suzette Labastilla accepted in the student university mobility program, exchange program with Toyo University, Japan. So I just want to share to you their learnings, no, and their experience during their exchange program. And this happened online.
Opportunities are boundless and learning never stops. My experience at Toyo University has been amazing. Studying international tourism courses has enabled me to showcase our country to foreign students from Japan, China, Inner Mongolia, and Hong Kong. Although the setup was in online mode, it gave us the opportunity to learn and grow in a stimulating and multicultural environment. I am thankful to the University of Mindanao, Dean Florence Cristina Jimenez, Professor Clarence Arcaraz, Professor Lily Balagman, and Ms. Isa Montadramas of Yuryao for believing that I can represent the university as an exchange student and making all of this happen. I encourage my fellow students to apply if an opportunity. Because I know that whatever next year exchange students' experience might be, they will surely love it too. This is Rhea Susetti Labastilla saying, Daghang Salamat UM.
Being an international student at Toyo University really opened up my eyes that there is more the world could give and that there is more to life outside of my own zone. All of the experience was such a privilege and an honor to be part of. This journey made me live life as a better person, believing in myself more, and being inspired to dream bigger. I am deeply grateful for all the people who believed in my capabilities, starting off from my professors in UM, Professor Algaraz, Professor Lagman, down to our professor at Toyo University, Professor Lawrence Pogendorf, and to our dean, Florence Cristina Jimenez, and to Ms. Isa Monte de Ramos of AREA. Thank you for the trust that I can represent UM in an international scale and that I can offer something more to the world. This has been Kyla Ninya G. Base. Salamat, UM.
Okay, so that's it, no? And in the areas of competitions, no, as we believe that we need to engage our students on the experience to compete, we send students national on the national level to compete in tour guiding. So this happened in Trinity University of Asia in Quezon, no? City, Manila, Philippines, when we compete on the Union of Filipino Tourism Student Skills Olympics. Aside from tour guiding, we have competed as well in the flight attendant showmanship, quiz bee, travel writing and photography, and also tour package proposal. And I am happy to say that also we won on the following competitions. So in the new normal, now I just want to update you that still there are still competitions happen virtually, and the University of Mindanao College of Hospitality Education also exposed our students to online competitions. So one of that, no, these are the proof na sumali ang ating mga students sa virtual tour guiding, sustainable destination marketing and recovery plan, travel website making, and travel writing and photography. Also, we have joined in the national competition for GDH MAP, Male and Female Ambassador. And alam nyo ba na among the participants, no, from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao ay nanalo ang UM, no, for being the champion for GDH MAP Male Ambassador. And we have our student, no, became a champion, Christian Marl Tatan. So this is a short video lang. So this is our student from UM. So this is Christian Marl Tatad, though, became the champion of the national competitions in Junior Tourism and Hospitality Management Association of the Philippines Ambassador. And we have also joined international conference, no, because we aim to expose our students not only on the local and domestic, but also international. So this is our student, Lila Rose Revillesa, competed on the Mixed Turismo. And I just want to showcase to you her advocacy, because in tourism, we are more on campaigning our environment, protecting our heritage and culture.
Philippines, a country that is rich in culture and traditions, abundance with natural resources, beautiful beaches, and delicious fruits. Those gifts we have are such a gem that all of us must take care of it. My advocacy focuses on sustainable development and supporting locals. As an individual, we should take care of our nature, especially in our own houses. I encourage everyone to use eco bags and limit the use of plastics, and remember the three R's: reduce, reuse, and recycle. They say, tangkilikin ang sariling atin. We can elevate and promote local products. Aside from its beauty and significance, it embodies who we are. It provides a sense of identity that facilitates common understanding and values. That's why we should buy local products. Together, we promote sustainability and local products.
Okay, so that's it. So this is the time when we won as the overall second runner-up in the national level competition. So in the picture, me and together with Professor Lagman and our students, no, from Davao, nagbiyahe kami papunta ng Manila to join, no, competitions on Quiz Bee, domestic tour guiding, international tour package proposal, and thankfully, no, we are thankful, we are blessed by the Almighty God, nanalo kami, no, from Mindanao, no. We compete with famous schools like Far Eastern University, De La Sal, and the rest of the largest university. So, ibinadendera namin ang flag ng UM. And lastly, no, as I am on the part to end this discussion, I just want to inspire our senior high school student, no, to enroll and choose Hospitality Management and Tourism Management Program by the testimony of our graduate. No? Here we have Mary Joyce M. Velvanueva. She is a graduate of BS Tourism Management Batch 2015. And right now, no, and she became a flight attendant in Cebu Pacific. We also have Brian Samson, a graduate of BS Tourism Management, University of Mindanao, Batch 2019. And also he landed a job being a cabin crew at Cebu Pacific. We also have here Dan Joseph B. Ferolino, a graduate of BSTM, Batch 2017. He became the MICE officer sa Manila ngayon, main office of Tourism Promotions Board and MICE Promotions Department. We also have a graduate, no, also of UM, BSTM, Michael John Dionio, working on the Department of Tourism, and also Genevieve Pasino, Batch 2012, now working in a cruise line. And the rest of the graduates, so from Hospitality Management, they became a chef, they became a business owner, and at the same time, teachers and professionals. So right now, before I end my discussion, is I just want you to give you a tour, no, here in our college, no, our College of Hospitality Education, Hospitality and Tourism Management Program. So this is a video that will highlight the La Special Hotel of UM and our students. Thank you.
chose University of Mindanao Tourism Management because of its high-quality education, student-friendly class schedules, modern facilities, national and global recognitions, and of course, highly qualified professors. I believe that being part of this institution will lead me to a brighter future.
Okay, and lastly, to also expose and highlight the hospitality management career. So this is the finale video. Are you ready? And in summary, earn your degree in hospitality and tourism management. Learn from experienced practicing educators. Engage with different people through immersion in global setting. Choose the different areas of specialization. And it's very important to our senior high school students to enhance, upskill your competencies because it's very important to impact others through a variety of career that awaits you. So I hope that you will choose University of Mindanao. Thank you very much for listening.
All right. So thank you very much, Professor Clarence, for those details with regards to those activities and even things that they can have once they would also pursue the hospitality management and also tourism management. And even in hospitality and tourism industry. So those are the professions that you can take once you would pursue tourism and also hospitality management. And it was mentioned here, there's a question from Charlie Byron, ma'am. If how much po yung semester sa tourism management?
Mama.
Yes, ma'am.
Sorry, na if they are, if they want to enroll in HM, ang semestral is nasa 15 to 16 thousand, I guess, or bench.
I think it's in 22 to 24 no, for those ano. For full load no ng mga students. Yes, so it depends upon the units no na kukunin mo. But for more information, you can also ask no our student accounting office no for you to have the full detail no of per yes. semester. But it would only range to 22 to 24k per semester. Ayun, so there's also a question, but this is this will be also discussed later, Anna, with regards to scholarships. All right. Ayan, so HRM and BH Tourism Management. So ganun lang yung range din nila once you would start no first I like first year. No, but then nagataas sa ma'am no once mag 30 and 40 I guess because of the laboratories.
Yes, yes, revenge because there are a lot of laboratory activities.
Ayan. Okay, so those are activities, no, laboratory activities that will hone no your competencies and also your skills, no, to become one no of those professions, no, in the hospitality and tourism management. Ayan. Other questions pa from our students from our senior high school for hospitality management and also tourism management? Baka meron pa kayong gustong i-clarify. So I think there's none, ma'am. All right.
Yes, Sir Benj, and they can also our official website, Facebook page. No, they can visit. Aside from University of Mindanao, they can also check the UM College of Hospitality Education about more details about the program, HRM and tourism. Thank you very much, Sir Benj.
Ayan. Thank you so much again, Professor Clarence. No, for though your discussion with regards to hospitality and tourism management industry. All right, so I guess now you're ready for another quiz, online quiz. So again, as I have mentioned, of course, we will be giving 100 peso load for those for the student, no, who can be on the top. All right, so please prepare your cell phones. Oh, no, your laptops, please go to menti.com and use the code 7901-4501. Don't forget to write your name. All right, it's 7901-4501. All right, let's go. Come on, join. And have a chance to win a 100 peso load or a GCash now from the University of Mindanao. Ayan, so we're waiting also from our students who's watching right now in our official YouTube channel. And we would like to recognize also schools who are here right now, aside from those schools that I've mentioned a while ago. Hello, hello sa mga students from Ateneo de Davao University Senior High School. We also have Pearl Libertad National High School. Welcome to our webinar. We also have Catalunan Pequeño National High School. Welcome to our webinar and hope you are enjoying and also you have learned a lot, no, from our discussions, no, from the first topic until to the topic with regards to tourism and hospitality management. So I guess madami-dami na and you're very excited to really win, no, 100 peso load. So let's go. Let's start our quiz. Here we go. All right. Sige. Answer fast to get more points. Here's the first question. Which of the following is a tourism management competency? Look at your phone. Is it food and beverage, front office, housekeeping? Tourism management competency. What do you think is the right answer? 3, 2, 1, and time's up. Let's see kung saan mas madaming answer, food and beverage, but no, the correct answer is front office. Food and beverage and housekeeping, no, are part of the hospitality management competency. All right. Let's see who is on the leaderboard, who's on top. So right now it's Shandy And then next to Shandy is Kaitana, and then Athena. Ayun. And then Von. So parang bumabawi si Athena. Kailangan niyang manalo ng 100 pesos. Come on. All right. Sige, let's go. Let's have the second question. Right answer fast to get more points. Here's the question. Which of the following is a hospitality management competency? Look at your phone. Is it the cookery, tour guiding, or tourism promotion? 10 seconds to answer. Three, two, one, and time's up. Most of you answer cookery, and that's correct. Okay, let's see who's on the leaderboard, who's on top. I think no, nawala yung top natin kanina. And here we go. It's Athena from third, naging first si Athena on our second question. Second is Kaitana, and then Von Andre, and then Charlie Byron. All right, let's go. Let's have the third question. Kaya pa yan. And answer fast to get more points. Here's the question. Which of the following is a possible career for tourism management? Look at your phone. Resident manager, ticketing manager, banquet director. 8 seconds to answer the question. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and time's up. Let's see kung saan ang mas madaming answer. Most of you said it's ticketing manager and you got it. 20 of you got the correct answer. And let's see who's on the leaderboard. Would it still be Athena Kao Sing on the first? I think it's still Athena. Oh no, it's Kaitana right now. Second si Athena Kao Sing. Von Andre is still on the third. Mikaela is the fastest in this round. Let's see. So, kaya yan. All right, let's have the second to the last question. It's between Kaitana and Athena right now. But let's see what will happen. Which of the following is a possible career for hospitality management? Training manager, destination manager, or tour guiding? 8 seconds to answer the question. 4, 3, 2, and 1, and time's up. Let's see kung saan mas madaming answer. Most of you said it's training manager and you got the correct answer. 16 of you got the correct answer. Sa 16 ba ito, na ito, would it still be Kaitana on the first? Let's see on our leaderboard. Oh, I think here's another person who's be on the top, and it's Athena, right? Athena versus Kaitana. Charlie right now is on the third and he's the fastest on this round. Let's see for the last question. Charlie, I'm rooting for you. Come on. All right, let's go. Here's the last question. Answer fast to get more points, and here's the question. What is the meaning of mice? Ayan. Sinabi yan kanina ni Prof. Clarence. So, it's up to you right now to answer, to click the right answer. 4, 3, 2, and 1, and time's up. Let's see kung saan ang mas madami. All right, 13 of you got the correct answer. It's meeting, incentive, convention, and exhibit. Here we go. Here is the decision. All right. Let's see the result. Would it still be sino ba yung kanina? It's Athena and then Kaitana and then Charlie. So let's see who is our winner for this round. Here we go. Dun 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 dun. And our winner for this quiz is no other than. All right. Alright, so it's Athena Kao Sing. Alright, congratulations Athena. You are our winner on this quiz natin. So please, give me your number sa chat box o di kaya sa kung nasa YouTube ka ngayon. So isulat mo lang yung number mo so that we can give you your prize. Alright, congratulations. Taga saang school ba si ano? Si Athena? Anong school? All right, from UM. All right. So congratulations. Ayan. So, sige lang. Kaya pa yan later. We still have another. Congratulations. Alright. So, I'll just write your number. So, nakinig talaga kayo, sila, ma'am, no, sa discussion mo kanina. Alright. Okay. So, for a while. So, we will now, no, proceed to the next topic. No, we're done with the pre-employment requirements. We're also done, no, with those information with regards to HRM and also tourism management. So this time, no, allow us, no, to also promote, no, to also give you, no, the things, no, that you can have once you enroll in the University of Mindanao and why it is very necessary or beneficial, no, and economical, no, to enroll or to pursue your college or to pursue your higher education here in the University of Mindanao. No, for 75 years, no, of giving service, no, to the Filipino, no, people or Filipino students, UM is really in the first, no, of leadership education with its quality, affordable, and open education. So for 75 years, the University of Mindanao has made equality higher education more accessible and more affordable to Filipinos, no, aiming for a college degree. All right. So always changing with the needs of the times, the University of Mindanao has remained relevant, very dynamic, and also steadily gone international in areas of student and faculty development. So also in terms of research. So that's why UM is first in leadership education. And why you should choose UM? There are actually reasons why choose UM. First of that, of course, because of its quality education. UM is actually a leading private institution in the region because of its accolades and also its awards, no, that and also accreditations na ina-applyan ni UM to really give quality education to the students. So this quality education, no, made this aim of UM, no, to become a leading private institution in the region, not just in the region but also in the whole Philippines. UM is the first university in Mindanao and Visayas granted an ISO accreditation. This is an international accreditation, a standardization that we're in. Once we have that one, that means your standards are actually aligned, no, with the standards in international schools. Another is UM is the first and only school granted with the Category A status by the Commission on Higher Education, or also called as CHED. So imagine that one, the higher education in the senior high, that's actually Department of Education. In the college, in higher education, that's Commission on Higher Education. So imagine a Category A, no, na status. Another is UM is also one of the three universities in Davao region granted autonomous status by the Commission on Higher Education. So autonomous status, that's actually being recognized, no, of kaning CHED, no, Commission on Higher Education. Recognize also si UM in terms of CHED, no, as a center of excellence in terms of teacher education, business administration, and criminology. Center of development naman in terms of accountancy, computer engineering, computer science, information technology, mechanical engineering, and even the hospitality, no, management. So UM is also recognized in the Philippine Association, no, Philippine Association of the College and Universities Commission on Accreditation, and that's PACOCOA. Granted also si UM ng certificate of accreditation in the Philippine Technological Council, no, for its programs na mechanical engineering, computer engineering, and also electrical engineering program. So with that, no, you can really say that the University of Mindanao is really committed to this, what we call giving quality education to its students. Another, no, reason why choose UM, because of its flexible schedule. Why do I say flexible schedule? Because of it's what we call term system. No, pag nasa term system, diba, in your senior high school, you have one semester, right? And in that one semester, you have 8 subjects. And all those 8 subjects will be tackled, no? May mga quizzes dyan, exams, lahat yan. Kailangan mong mag-study, no? Because all of those subjects will be taken. But in UM, through its term system, it's different. Why? Because this one semester, no, it will be divided into 2 terms. All right? So there's first term and the second term. In the first term, you will only take 4 subjects. All right? And then another one term, so that's another 4 subjects. So that means you are going in 2.5 months, you're just going to focus 4 subjects. And then another 2.5 months, another 4 subjects. So unlike the semestral, that all of those subjects will be taken. All right? So at least you can really focus, no, on those subjects, no, na really you would really focus and have that attention, no, to those subjects, all right? And aside from that, because of its flexibility, what you can do, no, with the term system, you can actually choose, no, what time would you like to take those subjects. And for example, all your subjects will be taken during the morning schedule. You can do that one here in UM. You can choose whether morning, afternoon, or evening. And imagine, 4 hours lang yan, kasi 4 subjects lang man. 4 hours lang yung ilalagay mo for your studies. Then afterwards niyan, no, you can go wherever you want, no? You can study or have your part-time job, no? Or you make gala-gala, okay? So that's very flexible. That's why there are a lot of students enrolling here in UM, especially those students who would like to have their work and also have their schooling. Ayan. So if you're planning to have that kind of setup, no, once you want to go to once you graduate, no, in the senior high, no, UM can really help you in terms of your schedule. No, that can really help you, no, in terms of pursuing your dreams. So flexible schedule, no, talks about, no, efficiency, focus, and quality. So di ba very quality siya? It's nga, you just have to focus 4 subjects. All right? 4 subjects lang yan. Siya dili makum laude, masuma cum laude, no? Madins tester because of that flexibility of the schedule. So, yun. And another thing is that UM is the most affordable private university in the region. Mind you guys, private university. Okay? So, you don't compare UM, no, to other public, private university. I mean, private schools na hindi university. And then, you should not also compare UM to mga state university. Alright? Because, yun nga, no, in terms of its status na private university. So, you have to compare them to those also who has the status of private university. And among all those, UM has the most affordable na tuition fee. Alright? Here in the Davao region. Okay. And aside from that, there are a lot of academic programs doon na ino-offer si UM. And UM is the second, no, to UST to have a lot of academic programs now being offered. So if you want to know more about the academic programs being given by the University of Mindanao, you can go to the www.umindanao.edu.ph. And there you can see a lot of colleges, and then you click that one, and then you'll be able to see other programs, no, na ino-offer ni UM. And aside from that, di ba, nakita nyo kanina sa tour natin virtually na ang laki ng campus ng UM. So a video pa lang yon, but once you would be in a face-to-face manner, so you'll be able to see na ang laki talaga ng UM. And it's really a university. You can really feel that you are in a university student, no, once you will be here in the University of Mindanao. So imagine ang College of Accounting Education, iba yung building niya. And iba din yung building, no? So Mulacao pa ka, no? And going there to another building for another college. But what is good here in UM is meron tayong electronic car. And that's free. So once you enroll in UM and then kapuyan ka magbaktas, no, you can just wait, no, for that car, no, electronic car ng UM, the e-car, and then doon ihahatid ka so saan building yung klase mo. All right. And another thing, no, UM is also kaning very adaptable, no, to what is happening, no, right now. And UM has made, no, learning modes, no, and si UM kumuha siya ng isang learning management system na is also aligned, no, with the international, no, ay ginagamit ng mga students, no, outside the Philippines, mga international schools. They're using Blackboard Open LMS, and here in Mindanao, like, there are only two schools who's using this one. And in terms of learning, no, UM is very conducive because of its facilities. Nakita niyo man siguro kanina yung mga facilities ng College of Health and College of Hospitality Education. You can really see that we are really aiming for quality, no? And through this conducive learning laboratories, no, for you guys who would like to pursue hospitality and tourism management ng mga courses. You can learn anywhere because it's a 28 hectare, no, na campus. There are a lot of benches, there are a lot of mga kaning stog ani, there are a lot of study hubs, no, that you can be here in the University of Mindanao. There's comfort really, and you can really focus on your studies. And right now, because of its pandemic, there's online and very conducive then, no, for students, no, na nag-enroll sa UM because of this learning management system. All right. And aside from that, UM is an open education university. That means UM, no, is really open to everyone. There's no discrimination here in the University of Mindanao because UM believes that everyone should have that high quality access to education. So that's the vision, no, of the founding father of the University of Mindanao, and that's Willie Torres Sr. And what is good is that everyone, no, can really be part of the University of Mindanao regardless of your status, regardless of your gender, your ethnicity, anyone, even in terms of your intellect. As long as pasado ka sa senior high, you can enroll to the course that you want to. All right? Basta pasado lang. So, yun. And aside from that, UM has no uniform. I mean, before to has no uniform, UM has no entrance exam. No, so maraming nag-chat, no, sa FB page namin na kailan ang entrance exam ng UM. To tell you guys, there's no entrance examination in UM. As long as meron kang card, no, you can enroll right away to the course that you want to. No, di na pwede na salaon pa na, ay, ikaw pang ganito ka, ganyan. Yeah? So as long as you want that course, you want that program, you can enroll in UM. And aside from that, UM has no uniform. Wala siyang uniform, no, because we adhere to also the international standards, no, like if you see, no, sa mga movies, no, na ang mga nasa university, they have no uniforms. But of course, there are rules, no, what are those mga attire na acceptable, no, in terms of decency, kailangan din natin 'yon. So what is good is that you can be what you want, no, you can have your fashion statement here in the University of Mindanao, and you will not be discriminated. All right? So that's why it's an open education university. No entrance examination or no admission and exam, and also there's no uniform. All right? So with that, no, the result, no, of this open education na policy ni UM, no, everyone has an opportunity to get the education that they want to. UM is the leading institution in terms of having a lot of top-notchers. No, since 2014, we have been recording, no, a lot of top-notchers from the different programs of the university. More than 120 top-notchers since 2014. And what is good once you become a top-notcher, no, to those board courses, no, you will have an incentive. Imagine once you become top one, it's either 500,000 or 1 million, no. There are programs pa kasi na 1 million pa din ang kanilang ang gin-offer ng university for them once they top, no, the examination. But you imagine who can give a half million to you once you become a top one. So, 'di ba, very exciting 'yun. If you're aiming for that, you become top notcher and to have this incentive, you can really make it, no? Because UM really help you, no? To get the goals that you want in life. And aside from that, guys, no? Just to encourage you, no? Di lahat, no? Ng mga nasa top notcher are in mga cum laudes or laudes. Others are very, yung mga simple lang, no? Hindi masyadong nasa limelight, but they are able to top, no? And then they got the incentives. Imagine that one. So from top 1 to top 10, binibigyan yan an incentive ng University of Mindanao. And because of that generosity, that's why, no, UM is very blessed, no, in terms of how it expanded, no, internationally. All right. So with that, no, we can say that once you enroll in UM, you can be assured that it will become the best decision you will ever make. And to know more about the University of Mindanao, please follow us on our social media pages and also on our website. So for Facebook, YouTube, we also have Twitter and also Instagram, and we also have TikTok. And for more information with regards to admission, scholarship, you can go to our website, the www.umindanao.edu.ph. All right. So, and we also say advance congratulations on your graduation day. I know that you're very excited for this. No, gamay na lang, konting kembot na lang, and you will be graduating on your senior high school. Ayun. So congrats sa inyo, ha. Ayun. So thank you very much, no, for also joining, no, our tawag nito, our webinar this afternoon. So congratulations. So hopefully, no, na you're able to gain friends also here dito sa ating webinar ngayon. So hopefully sinat nyo na yung mga other students, no? It's a Davao wide, no? It's region wide, no, na mga participants dito, no? Not just here in Davao City, but also even in Soccsargen meron tayong mga participants dito. All right? And also don't forget, no, again to tawag nito, to follow us, no, on our social media pages. Now, before that, no, if you have questions with regards to scholarships, admissions, please unscreenshot this one, no, and also you can text or call these numbers for scholarships. Kung meron kayong, if you're asking for scholarships, but right now what we're offering is yung academic scholars. Like for example, you graduated in the senior high school as highest honor and high honor, so it's like 100% and 75% of your tuition fee, so it will be all offered to you. But in terms of cultural, like dancing, singing, no, kasi meron tayong University of Mindanao Choral, meron tayong University Band, we also have University Makabayan Dance Ensembles. But right now we're not offering it, no, because nga of the pandemic. So what we can offer, no, are those academic scholarship. But once you enroll in UM, no, kasi and once you you're able to have those grades, no, na malalaki, no, like 85 above of your grades, and you have that average of 90%, no, you can also avail, no, the scholar and academic scholars of the university, and you have to maintain, no, your grade. Same thing those students who will enroll in UM na nakagraduate as with highest honor and with high honor, so you have to maintain your grade so that you can also maintain your scholarship. And aside from that, if you have questions with regards to admission and registered office, please call on those numbers. And UM personnel will help you with your questions. All right. So baka meron pa kayong questions, so would like to clarify with regards to what UM can offer to you guys once you would also enroll, no, on those hospitality and tourism management. Now, in terms of face-to-face class, of course, we are really, really willing to have that face-to-face class, guys. Now, we're also excited to see you here in the university. Ngunit ay maglakaw-lakaw ng mga estudyante, no, magdinaganay dito sa pathway. Now, you can experience that one once we'll have the face-to-face. But of course, UM is adhering to those policies, no, ng IATF. Now, once Davao City will be in the level 0, so basically, no, we can have the face-to-face. No, but keep updated lang kasi right now, we're having our limited face-to-face. Right, Ma'am Clarence? Are you still there, ma'am? diba, meron pa rin tayong face-to-face no, na limited face-to-face. So for next school year, let's see no, what will happen. What would be the policies no, of their government in terms of the restrictions and also safety. Kasi of course, life no, is yung priority talaga ng government. But basically, no, UM is very ready for a face-to-face, yung full blast talaga na face-to-face. Right? But of course, we have to follow the government. No? So, yun. So let's just wait for that, Athena. All right. Ano pa? Baka you have other questions pa. Meron pa ba? Still have questions? All right. So I think you don't have questions already. So let's go to the next last quiz natin. We are also having our online class right now. Okay. So meron pa si IV. Online class CUM, but then again, as I have mentioned, we are already ready no, for the face-to-face. So the government na lang na mga policies ang hinihintay natin. So we're also very excited to see you guys here in our campus. So hopefully, no, soon, no, we will get through this. All right? Okay, so let's have now our last quiz. Again, 100 peso load no, will be given to the winner. Alright? Sige. Please go to menti.com and then use the code 3556-3238. Let's go. Now we're waiting for players for this. This is the last question. Okay. So while waiting no, for the participants to go to menti.com, Julie asks here if my weekend po ba si UM. Unfortunately, we don't have yung parang Sunday school classes no here in UM. So daily siya, no. So and anyways, what is good is that 4 hours ka lang pupunta sa school because nga of its term system. Ayan. So depende na sa iyo if morning ka or afternoon or evening, depende kung saan ka available. Anong gusto mo na schedule for you na convenient for you to really learn and to manage your time. But in terms of yung parang Sunday school classes, UM is not offering that one. Alright, so more players pa. Okay, hopefully, no, yung mga nasa YouTube, they are now ready and excited no, for, tawag nito, for our quiz. Ayan. No, I think we're good. No, let's start our quiz. Last quiz natin. Right, let's go. Here we go. Answer fast to get more points. Here is the first question. UM offers quality, affordable, and blank education. Look at your phone. Open, free, or exclusive? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And everyone has voted. Time's up. Most of you says it's open. That's correct. 16 of you got the correct answer. But let's see who's on the top. It's Venus. Then Vaughn. And then Garjoyce. All right. Then Shandy. Okay. Sige. Let's go. Let's have the second question. Answer fast to get more points. Here's the question. UM has no entrance exam. Is this true or false? Oh, paspasa na ka-answer. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Everyone has voted and says it's true. Yes, correct. It's true. UM has no entrance exam because nga of its open education policy. Alright. Sige, let's see. Kung sino yung nasa leaderboard natin. Will it still be Venus? And, ay, parang tie. Still, it's Venus. Alright? And then Vaughn. Okay, let's have the third question. Answer fast to get more points. Here's the question. UM has how many terms in one semester? Yun, sinabi ko yun kanina. Look at your phone. 3 terms, 2 terms, or 4 terms? 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Everyone has voted. All right, the correct answer is two terms. All right, would it still be Venus on the first place? Or parang meron ng bagong? Ayun, it's not Von. I expected it to be Von, but it's Carl Aaron Mejias. All right, and then second si CBM33. Okay, oh, parang gustong-gusto pa ni Kaitana ng another 100 na load. Okay, she's on the fourth place right now. We still have two questions. Ayan. Second to the last question, answer fast to get more points. UM has school uniform. True or false? Everyone has voted and the correct answer is false. Walang uniform si UM. So OOTD every day dito sa UM. Ayan. All right. Sige. I think we have another first place and it's CBM23. Von is on the second place. Von, I'm rooting for you. All right. Here's the last question. Kaya pa yan, Von. But of course, di yan papayag si CBM23 na madislad siya. Okay, I am planning to enroll in UM. This is the very difficult question. Look at your phone. Yes or no? Alright. Okay, 10 seconds to answer. So CBM23, ikaw ba ang aming winner for this? Or merong iba? Time is up. Everyone has voted and most of you would like to enroll in UM. Ayun. So, let's see if it is CBM23 ang panalo dito. Here we go. Here is our leaderboard. And our winner is loading results. Alright. Pinatagal pa talaga. And our winner is it's CBM23. Ah, the fastest one. Congratulations. Sino kaya to si CBM? No, nag pseudonym. Who's CBM? All right. So, sino ba? Congratulations CBM23, sino yan siya? All right. So, please send me your number here sa chat or baka nasa sa YouTube. Let's see. Tingnan natin. Baka sa YouTube. All right. Okay, wala din. So, sino nanalo? Is that you, Charles, Brian? Ah, CBM. Okay. Charles Brian Manlangit from UM Maine. Ah, UM pa din ang ano. Alright, congratulations no for being our winner. So, pakihatag na lang sa imuhang number dere so that I can load it. No, later, maglo-load na ako sa inyohang mga winners. Alright. Rosabel, you're raising your hand. You want to ask a question? Mga meron pa kayong final question, guys? I can still entertain questions. Meron pa ba? So parang na-raise lang ata ni Rosabel, no? Ang kanyang okay na siya. All right, okay na pala. So again, congratulations to all the winners and thank you very much no for joining our tawag nito, our webinar this afternoon. Okay, before you leave, guys, no, of course kailangan ninyo ang inyong certificate. So please have this evaluation. No, meron akong bibigay na evaluation form. All right. So para maibigay namin sa inyo ang inyong certificate. All right. So for a while. All right. There you go. Okay? So also andun sa YouTube channel, please click the link or copy the link and then i-ano ninyo ang inyong evaluation form and then later on it will be emailed to you. So please lang dapat yung email tama, no? Make sure na tama ang spelling, no? Kasi hindi yan mabigay sa inyo once wrong ang spelling ng email ninyo. All right? So once tapos na kayo with the evaluation, ibibigay namin ang certificate sa inyo through your email address. All right? All right. So again, in behalf of the University of Mindanao, we say congratulations to every one of you. Congratulations on your graduation day, and we hope no that you will have your success no on your chosen journey. Gusto niyo ba mag-work or you want to pursue your higher education? And in terms of your higher education, the UM is always here to help you to get the dreams that you want in life. All right? And of course, no, to inspire you guys, no, with regards to what are the things that you want, no, to pursue, no, after your senior high school, here's a performance from the University of Mindanao Coral. Hope it will inspire you guys. Hi everyone. So soar high and fly high. Bye bye everyone. God bless. Bye bye.